story, for example, is in Amsterdam last week, the very first common fare kiosk opened, and I've seen pictures and I've seen the report from the partners that are doing this kind of research in the Netherlands, and it was super funny to see a municipal policeman besides an old woman, clearly a migrant, non-Western one, and some people, there were Dutch, different ages, there was a teenager, and these eight people moving around with the post-it and try to design how they would have the actual platform. And I think that is important to underline. Another thing that I like of the project is that it's not a problem solver and not even a problem finder. People are telling what they need and what they want, and that's why it's important that it is current needs and current desires, and then we try all together to build something that of course leverages also on the digital opportunities that we have now and can help in connecting people and networking opportunities and get to know more information and share through storytelling. But the bottom line to me is to understand the current problem in equality, economic situation, financial condition of people, and so life condition in the end, and to try to do something about that. Mm-hmm. This is my drive.
Do you have, let's say, an example, a story very close when you describe people? What do you have in mind?
A lot of people, actually, of course. And well, I come from ethnography, so my work is usually with people. And this is actually the first time that I'm not in frontline research, but behind in coordination of different research teams. The tradition starts from participatory design, action research. I also think that there are a lot of new terms about these things that is basically always the same thing, which is starting from the people, from who is going to not only use but also co-construct and reinvent, continuously reinvent, because the technology we are designing now works precisely like other technologies, and within technology I put also the wheel, for example. And this reconnects to me to the importance of the materiality. Having people in co-presence in a space, doing stuff with things. So the very basic definition of co-design to me is this one. Then of course it is also important some theoretical reflection that helps you not taking things for granted, keeps reflecting. For example, I've just this morning seen an article about diversity and a critique of the concept of diversity, because it takes into consideration just, you know, for example, in gender terms, just for women being or not in some position of power and hierarchy and so on, but not what happens, and again we are at the co-presence, materiality, interaction and affect, what happens within these environments on a daily basis, everyday life. It is another way to underline differences among people, and not differences in terms of diversity or interdisciplinarity and whatever, differences in terms of specific variables under which we categorize people. So people categorization along these variables is a problem per se, because it's represent society in a static way, and also of course in a hierarchical way, and so I would try to avoid as much as possible this kind of categorizations, and gender enters the picture.
Yes, of course.